Friends, the given problem is verify Stokes' theorem for f bar is equal to x square plus y square times half I minus 2xyj. Taken round the rectangle bounded by the lines x is equal to plus or minus a, comma y is equal to 0 to y is equal to b. Right. Now you see we have to verify Stokes' theorem. What is the Stokes theorem statement we have? Nothing but a formula for the Stokes theorem. We have integral over C f bar dot dr bar is equal to double integral over S curl f bar dot n bar ds. Friends, you see this is the formula for the statement for the Stokes theorem. In this one they are given verify Stokes theorem. Verify is nothing but we have to prove LHS part is equal to RHS part. LHS part you observe, this is a along only curve they are given. Nothing but it is a line integral. And right side you have a along the surface. That is here you have a double integral type, surface integral. So the relation between line and surface integral is called Stokes theorem. And moreover you observe, in the Stokes theorem, while doing the Stokes theorem, third ordinate we won't take. Either you will take xy axis or xy plane or yz plane or zx plane only we will take. Right, now you see here we are verifying the Stokes theorem for f bar. What is the f bar here? You see x square plus y square times of I minus 2xyz bounded by the rectangle. Rectangle is here, you see x is equal to plus or minus a, y is equal to 0 comma b. First I am drawing the region. This is x axis and y axis on the xy plane. X value plus a comma minus a. So first this is minus a comma 0 and this is a comma 0. When x is minus a y 0, when x is plus a y 0. Next when x is minus a y is equal to b. Plus a y is equal to b. Let it be here, this is a b. So this is the point a comma b. Next when x is minus a y is equal to b. Consider same, so this is minus a comma b. Now you draw the figure, then this is the our rectangle. Now in this case you consider this the point A, point B, point C, point D. Now we have to verify Stokes theorem around the rectangle bounded by these vertices. Is it clear? Right. Now first verify is nothing but I am doing right side part. Sometimes may they will give this problem. Evaluate integral f bar dot dr bar is nothing but it is enough to find out the RHS part. Right. If verify is nothing but LHS part also we have to do, and we have to prove both should be equal. Now coming to the RHS part. In the RHS part we have curl f bar dot n bar ds. Curl f bar dot n bar ds. Do you know f bar? Yes. Now we need to find out curl f bar and n bar. And ds is also. Ds is nothing but that is in xy plane or yz plane or zx plane. Right. Now you see f bar is equal to we have x square plus y square I minus 2xyj. Now del cross f bar. Curl f bar is nothing but del cross f bar. That is I j k. Dou by dou x. Dou by dou y. Dou by dou z. Here I quotient is what I have, x square plus y square. J quotient in f bar minus 2xy. K quotient, is there any k? No k, nothing but you can say 0 k, 0 times of k. So this is 0. Now you observe I into with respect to y 0 and with respect to z there is a no z term, that is why the derivative partially with respect to z is here of minus 2xy is equal to 0 minus j times of. With respect to x, do it here? No. Here j times if you have done, then you will have with respect to x is also 0. Next with respect to z, 0. Plus k times of. With respect to x if you have done, this is the function of x and y. So minus 2y is a constant, x derivative is 1. So minus 2y. Minus with respect to y. With respect to y means here you have a 2y. So this is minus 2y. So minus 2, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So you can say minus 4yk. Minus 4yk is which value? Curl f bar value. Now you want n bar. You observe friends, F bar, they are given F1i plus F2j form. F1i plus F2j form. They are not given F3k. Nothing but this is in xy plane. Is there any z term here? No, they are not given any z value. Nothing but z is equal to 0. Dz is also 0 in this case. In that case, n bar will be what? K. N bar is equal to k. Now, del cross f bar dot n bar ds. Next, moreover, ds also we need to find out. Ds on xy plane mod n bar dot k. That is nothing but dx dy divided by k dot k. K dot k is 1. So, you will have dx dy only. Now, del cross f bar dot n bar ds is equal to minus 4y k times of dot product of k into this is dx dy. Dx dy. That is, you see, you will have finally minus 4y. Okay, minus 4y is which value? Curl f bar dot n bar ds value. Now we have to evaluate the surface integral here. Okay. Is it clear, friends? How we are done? First, we are done curl f bar. Next, n bar we are taken on xy plane. Xy plane n bar is equal to k we are taken here. Next, ds is here. Dx dy by mod n bar dot k is becomes dx dy only. Now I multiplied del cross f bar and n bar ds. Dot product of these two into ds. That is nothing but here you have k dot k is 1. So minus 4y you have outside. Now dx dy. Dx dy. Right. Now we have to evaluate RHS part. Double integral s. Curl f bar n bar ds value. What is the curl f bar dot n bar ds we have? Minus 4y dx dy. So here you see minus 4 I can write outside. Now I want the limits on the surface xy plane. In the xy plane. Xy plane what we have actually? That is a rectangle only we have. Rectangle or not here. On this rectangle, x is equal to what you have? Plus or minus a. And y is equal to 0 comma y is equal to b. So, x is moving from minus a to a. And y is from 0 to b. So, x is equal to minus a lower limit. Upper limit is a. And y lower limit is 0 to b. Right. Next, what you require actually? Y is there. Inside integrand is y dx dy. Here you observe both the x and y limits are independent. Both the x and y limits are independent. So you can do integration irrespective of order. Minus 4 times of. First I am doing with respect to y. Then I will have y square by 2. Limits of y are 0 to b. Next you have a dx quotient is 1. 1 integration is x. With respect to x is x. Limits from minus a to a. Now you see here. Minus 4 by 2 times of upper limit if I have substituted then I will have b square minus 0 square lower limit is 0 square is 0 into a minus of minus a is plus a. So here you see then we will have minus 4 by 2 is 2 times of b square into a plus a is 2a. So finally you will have minus 2 times of 2 is 4 a b square. This is which value? Double integral s. Curl f bar dot n bar ds. So, if they are given in the problem, evaluate is nothing but up to this is enough. But, what they are given in the problem? Verify Stokes theorem. Verify is nothing but you have to prove LHS is equal to RHS. Now, we are done RHS. So, up to evaluate, only evaluate if they are given this one, then RHS is enough. Now, we have to prove LHS also. LHS is equal to RHS. So we need to find out LHS value. That is nothing but line integral. So here f bar we have and limits of x and y we have. Now we have to do f bar dot dr bar. Given f bar is we have x square plus y square times of I minus 2xyj. Okay. Now we have to find out integral over c f bar dot dr bar. What is the dr bar actually we have? Dr bar in xy plane is dxi plus dyj. So in this case we will have closed interval c x square plus y square into dx because I dot I is 1. X square plus y square into dx f1 dx plus f2 dy only not f3 dz because there is no k quotient. K quotient is here 0 and here also you don't have f3. Right. So this is plus into minus. I can write here minus 2xy into dy. Now we have to evaluate this integration line integral along the closed curve. What is the curve we have actually? The curve is bounded by the rectangle. Yes or no? around the rectangle. What is the rectangle here? You see A, B, C, D. Vertices are, x limits are from minus A to A, and y is from here you have 0 to B. Now you see, I am considering these curves are first C1 curve, C2 curve, C3 curve, C4 curve. Clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction here? Positive direction is nothing but here anti-clockwise direction. Now along C1 you see, first along C1 is nothing but AB. Along C1, along C1, AB. AB is what you have point? A comma 0 to A comma B. So x is equal to here A, here A. So x value is not changed. So the rate of change in x is 0. Next y is moving from 0 to B. 0 to B. Next AB. So we have to integrate this one. Then in this case, this integral over C f bar dr along the only open curve, you see, just C1 curve with respect to y we are doing. Similarly, we have to do C2, C3, C4, because the closed curve, you see, integral C1 plus integral C2 plus integral C3, integral C4. Similarly, we have to take AB is completed now, BC, CD, DA. Next, we have to add these all values. Then you will get the final solution, integral over C, F bar, DR bar. Is it clear? Right. Here, I have written previously what we have done. So along C1, x value is equal to, x is equal to A, dx is 0, and y is moving from 0 to B. So C1 limits we have to take, y is equal to 0 to B. Next, in place of dx, we have to put 0. So this value entire will be 0. Only you will have this term. And moreover, on this place, what about in the coefficient of minus 2xy? X is there. One second. You see, I am writing here. This is minus 2xy dy. Now we have to integrate with respect to y. But the integrand is containing x term. So we have to replace x value in terms of y or in terms of any other. Okay. But in this y is equal to 0 to b, along the c1 we have x is equal to a. So in this case, minus 2 in place of x I can write here a only. So integral 0 to b a y into dy. So minus 2a I am writing outside. Y integration is y square by 2. Limits from 0 to b. So denominator 2 and numerator 2 is getting cancelled. Then you will have minus a into upper limit is b means b square, lower limit is 0 is nothing but 0 square. So you will have minus ab square. This is along the c1 curve. Clear? Next to, we have to evaluate along the c2. Along the c2. On the c2 you observe x is from x is equal to a and x is equal to minus a. Y is equal to b. Y is equal to b. So your y value is equal to b. Y is not changing in this case. So dy will be 0. This is along C2, B and C. Here you see B point to C point we are moving, nothing but BC. Here X is moving from A to minus A. And Y value you observe, B and here also B. So Y is doesn't change. So Y value is here B and rate of change is here 0. Now we have to evaluate the integral along the C2, F bar dot DR bar is from X is equal to A to minus A. Along the x axis only we are doing. Along the x line, that is from minus A to A. Now in place of dy we have to put 0. So you won't get this term. Only you will have this term. So I am writing first that one. X square plus y square into dx. But we are integrating with respect to x. But here what is the term you have? Integrand is containing y term. So replace y value. What is the y value along this C2? Y is equal to b. So in this case, x is equal to a to minus a, x square plus y square is nothing but b square into dx. See friends here, both are here. This is the constant and this is even terms. So you can write 2 times of integral 0 to a. This a to minus a, you can write 2 times of 0 to minus a. Anyway, you can do directly. This is, you will have x cube by 3 plus b square into b square is a constant, so b square into 1 you can add. Now x integration, 1 integration with respect to x is x. Limits from a to minus a. Now substitute upper limit, then you will have minus a cube by 3 plus a cube. Next, minus lower limit is a cube by 3 plus a cube. Now you see, this is, you will get here plus a cube minus a cube getting cancelled. Minus 2a cube by 3 is the, sorry, here both are same only. Sorry, here you see I have done a small mistake. If I substituted upper limit, then you will have minus a cube by 3. Next, here x is equal to minus a. So, you will have minus ab square. This is upper limit. Minus lower limit, you see. A cube by 3 plus ab square. That's it. Now, in this case, minus if you take in common, then these two terms will be same. You see, minus a cube by 3, minus a cube by 3. So, minus 2a cube by 3. Minus ab square, minus ab square. Minus 2ab square. So, minus 2 is a common. Then you will have a cube by 3 plus b square is the along c2. F bar dot dr bar is over. Next, you need to find out along c3. Okay. Now, you see c3, what we have? C3 is from c minus a to b and d minus a to 0. What is x value here? Minus a. Here also you have minus a. So, x value is doesn't change. See, this is a y-axis. Parallel to the y-axis means x value is equal to minus a and y is here b to 0, which is moving b to 0, right? This is c3 curve. Once again, I am repeating. C is from minus a. C is minus a comma b to d minus a comma 0. So, x value is equal to minus a and y is moving from. So, x value here minus a, here also minus a. So, what you can say in this case means dx is equal to 0. Rate of change in x is 0. Now, moving along the y-axis. From where to where? B to 0. So, c3 x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy. We are taking the limits. We are integrating along the y-axis from b to 0. Next, here dx is 0 means you won't take this term. Dx is 0. So, this term will be 0. Minus 2xy into dy we have. We are integrating with respect to y. But here integrand is containing x term. So, replace x term with minus a. Then you will have minus 2a. Outside minus is there. So, 2a integral b to 0 y dy. What is the integration of y? Y square by 2. Limits from b to 0. So, lower limit 2. Denominator and numerator getting cancelled. Then you will have. This is 0 minus b square. Nothing but here. Minus ab square is the along the c3 value. Is it clear? Next, along c4. Now, you see, c4 is nothing but here. D is minus a to 0, a to 0. This is x-axis. So, along the x-axis, which is point is moving x-axis. X is from minus a to a. On the x-axis, y value is what actually? 0 only. Okay. Anyway, you observe here, the point y is equal to 0. Here also 0. So, y value is 0. Rate of change of y is 0. That is, dy is equal to 0. Now, x is from minus a to a. See, here d value is minus a comma 0 and a is a comma 0. So, x is moving from minus a to a. What about the y value here? 0. Here also 0. So, y value is a constant. That is a 0. The rate of change is y is 0 here. Because it is not changing. Along the y axis, it is not changing. That is why dy is 0. Next. So, we are integrating c4 along the c4 with respect to x. From where to where? Minus a to a. In this case, dy value is 0. So, nothing but this integrand, this value will be 0 in the integration. Next, you have x square plus y square into dx. Now, we are integrating with respect to x. But here you have in the integrand y term. So, put y is equal to what? 0. So, in this case, minus a to a, x square dx only. Now, x square integration is x cube by 3. Limits from minus a to a. So, a cube by 3 minus of minus a cube by 3. So, total you will have 2 a cube by 3. So, this is along the c4. Now, I will write c4. You have no? Now, you see integral closed interval c f bar dot dr bar is equal to integral c1 f bar dot dr plus integral c2 f bar dot dr plus integral c3 f bar dot dr plus integral c4 f bar dot dr. Now you see along the c1 we have minus ab square. Along the c1 we have minus ab square. Right. Already I have done these values. Next, along the c2 minus 2a square by 3 minus 2ab square. Next, along C3 we have minus ab square. Next, along the C4 you have plus 2a cube by 3. By the observation, you see minus 2a cube by 3 we have here. Yes. Now, by the observation, we can say, one moment please, here you see, along the C2, I will check it. Along the C2, we have minus 2 times of a cube by 3 plus b square. So, a cube, I have written a square. So, this is a cube. Now, you see, minus 2a cube by 3 plus 2a cube by 3 is getting cancelled. Then, the remaining terms, what I have? Minus ab square, minus 2ab square, minus ab square. All are ab square is there. Ab square, minus 1, minus 2, minus 1. Nothing but minus 4. So, the integral over C, f bar dot dr bar is equal to minus 4ab square. And previously, we have double integral S, curl f bar dot n bar ds is equal to minus 4ab square. Therefore, both are equal or not. So, we can write integral over C, f bar dot dr bar is equal to double integral S, curl f bar dot n bar ds. So, the statement of the Stokes theorem is proved or not. Therefore, hence proved Stokes theorem. Is it clear? Friends, in the next video, we will change only surface. Right. Thank you for watching this video.